Dear learners, today we are going to discuss ladder friction. So before going to the frictional topic in ladder, first of all, we need to discuss the ladder. Okay. So ladder is a invention of the science, right? So ladder, it is useful to lift the person or lift the object from one level to the another level. Did you know ladder, the invention of the ladder, that is the idea of the ladder, sparked into the human brain by the nature? One day in a forest, there is a heavy rain and cyclone. During that time, a tree fall down over the another tree, it makes them some angle. The tribe people watch this thing. So the tribe people used to move into the tree using this fallen tree. So in that time, in the human being, that is the tribe people, have an idea of the ladder. After that, the tribe people made a simple ladder using the tree branches. After that, some bamboo trees, using bamboo trees, they made a wooden ladder. So this is the beginning of the invention of science in ladder. Okay, so today we are going to discuss the what is ladder friction, okay, and how to solve the problem on friction in the ladder. Okay, in our home or in our buildings, we are using ladders. Okay, so in our home, we are using portable ladders. That is, we can move anywhere from one place to another place. Otherwise, if the ladder is a fixed condition, that is, the both the edge of the ladder has been fixed using some connections, then it is called as a staircase. Okay. So in ladder, the materials of the ladder, it may be a wooden ladder or steel ladder. Nowadays, we have aluminium ladder also. Okay. So all the ladders are the portable ladders. I am talking about ladder, not staircase. Okay. So the ladder, the importance of the stability of the ladder. Okay. Because the ladder is at the floor level, the ladder has been rest, and the other edge of the ladder is rest on the wall. Okay. So these two edges should have some minimum friction, then only that ladder will not slip. Okay. So let me go into this topic, ladder friction. So let me draw the diagram of the ladder friction. So this is the surface, that is floor, and continuation with vertical wall. So here is the ladder. So the one end of the ladder is supported in the wall, and the other end of the ladder is supported at the floor. Now, so here there is a normal reaction. I am taking this point as A, and this is point B, this is RA, and this is RB. This ladder makes an angle of theta. This is the length of the ladder, L. The weight of the ladder is acting at the midpoint, W, the self weight of the ladder. If any person standing over the ladder, that weight is additionally acting with this ladder. So because of the frictional resistance, the ladder tries to slide in this direction towards left. To counteract this sliding, there is an opposite frictional resistance, FA. frictional resistance at point A, FA, and another here. Due to this self weight of the ladder and the additional weight due to some person, this point, that is in the wall point, the ladder tried to move downward. So to counteract this downward slip, there is an opposite upward frictional resistance FB. So here, this is L by 2, that is from any one edge of the ladder to the weight of the ladder acting at the center of the ladder. This is L by 2. L by 2. Let me draw the free diagram for this case. So, this is my axis. So, here the upward reaction in this direction. This is RA, and the downward load due to weight of the ladder W acting downwards, and the frictional resistance is in this direction, that is FA. Also, the reaction at point B at the wall surface is acting in this direction. That is RB. Also, there is another frictional resistance in the wall surface. This is FB. This is also acting upward direction FB. So, in vertical component, there is three forces. That is one load W and one normal reaction in upward direction at the floor. Also, in the wall, there is an frictional resistance. So, this is the free body diagram for this case. Okay. Now, let me tell you, the stability of the ladder is depends upon the three factors. Number one, the weight of the ladder and the angle of inclination and the roughness of the, that is frictional resistance of the surface. So, these three factors plays an important role whether the ladder may slide or not. Now, let me solve this ladder problem. So, using this free body diagram, first I am taking sum of all the vertical forces in horizontal direction which is equal to 0. This is the static equilibrium equation. Okay. So, here there is FA, that is FA plus FA because it is moved towards right hand side, minus RB which is equal to 0. There is no inclined or horizontal force, only two forces are there. From that FA which is equal to RB. We know frictional resistance FA which is equal to mu into RA. Mu into RA. So, here two surfaces are there, the vertical wall surface and the horizontal floor surface. I can take it this is mu frictional resistance at wall surface mu 2. And frictional resistance at the floor surface mu 1, because these two surfaces are different. This may be a tiled material or some different material. So, this wall surface may be a plastered surface. Okay. So, these two may be different frictional resistance values or sometimes same frictional resistance values. Coefficient of friction. So, FA equal to mu 1 into RA. Similarly, summation of FY which is equal to 0. So, minus W downward force plus RA upward reaction plus
FB which is equal to 0. From that W equal to RA plus FB. W equal to RA plus FB. Then here totally four unknown components are there. So here you need to take this point as O. You need to taking moment at point O. Taking moment at point O. Taking moment at point O. So here that is sum of M naught which is equal to 0. So here how will you take the moment components? First, this is RA into this distance. You can take it this distance as maybe x. So RA into, you are taking moment here, RA into x minus W into, maybe you can take it x by 2 minus W into x by 2 and this is RB. Can I take it? This is H. Height. RB into this height. RB into plus minus, sorry, minus RB into H. That's it. Which is equal to 0. So this is the sum of all the moment at point O, which is equal to 0. So we will see some of the problems in the ladder friction. Example number 1, a uniform ladder of weight 300 Newton rests against a smooth vertical wall, a rough horizontal surface floor making an angle of 60 degrees with the horizontal. Find the force of friction at the floor. So let me draw the diagram for this problem. This is floor surface and this is wall. A ladder is resting. Here. So here there is a vertical reaction. I am taking this is point A, this is RA, and this is RB, this is point B. It makes an angle of 60 degree with the horizontal floor. So this is 60 degree. Also, there is a frictional resistance here because the floor is rough. But the wall is smooth. Okay. So this is FA. So wall is smooth. So if the condition of wall is smooth means here as the wall is smooth. Smooth. Frictional resistance at B which is equal to 0. That is if the wall is smooth means there is no resistance here. Frictional resistance here. Okay. So there is some roughness required to resist the sliding of the ladder, right? So now as usual we can calculate the resolve the forces, summation of F x which is equal to 0. So here all horizontal forces is FA minus RB which is equal to 0. From that FA which is equal to RB. So here instead of FA I am substituting mu into RA which is equal to Rb. We know the general formula for frictional resistance, mu into Ra, or sometimes you can put N also, normal reaction. So this is about horizontal axis. On the other hand, sum of vertical forces, which is equal to 0. Fy, which is equal to 0. So here, Ra equal to, that is this one, Ra, here there is a downward load, that is the weight of the ladder is acting in downward direction W. So this value is given, this is 300 Newton. So Ra minus W, which is equal to 0. From that, Ra equal to W, which is equal to this weight, 300 Newton. So from that, you know the Ra, that is Fa equal to, Ra equal to 300 Newton. Fa, which is equal to mu into Ra, that is mu into 300, that is Ra equal to 300 mu. So assume here the frictional resistance, rough horizontal flow is given, but the coefficient of friction is not given. So that I am assuming the mu value as 0.3 between the ladder and the floor. In the wall is very smooth, so the frictional resistance, that is Fb, which is equal to 0, frictional resistance at B equal to 0, so there is no coefficient of friction is 0 here. So mu equal to 0.3, the force of friction Fa, that is small Fa, which is equal to 300 into mu, that is 300 into 0.3. So from that you will get Fa, which is equal to 90 Newton. Fa, which is equal to 90 Newton. So in the question, find the force of friction at the floor. This is the force of friction at the floor. So I will wind up this today's video presentation with this problem. In the next video presentation, we will discuss more problems on the ladder friction. Thank you all. Thank you very much for your watching this video.